स्टूडेंट, यस्टरडे वी लर्न प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ टू पैरेलल लाइन एंड इट्स ट्रांसवर्सल एंड दिस प्रॉपर्टीज आर व्हेन टू पैरेलल लाइन एंड वन ट्रांसवर्सल इज गिवन देन पेयर ऑफ करस्पोंडिंग एंगल्स आर कॉन्गुएंट पेयर ऑफ करस्पोंडिंग एंगल्स आर कॉन्गुएंट सेकंड प्रॉपर्टी इज पेयर ऑफ ऑल्टरनेट एंगल्स आर ऑल्सो कॉन्गुएंट एंड थर्ड प्रॉपर्टी इज पेयर ऑफ इंटीरियर एंगल्स आर सप्लीमेंट्री सो इन प्रैक्टिस सेट 2.2 सम क्वेश्चंस आर गिवन बेस्ड ऑन दिस थ्री प्रॉपर्टीज सो लेट अस कंसीडर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन गिवन दैट चूज द करेक्ट अल्टरनेटिव एंड इन फर्स्ट सब क्वेश्चन गिवन दैट इफ लाइन एम इज पैरेलल टू लाइन एन इन दैट फिगर लाइन एन इज पैरेलल टू लाइन एम एंड पी इज द ट्रांसवर्सल दिस पी इज द ट्रांसवर्सल देन फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स Then we have to find the value of x. Its options are given. Student, first we solve this question properly and then whatever the answer we get, then we take the correct alternatives. So, first we solve this question. So, first we write the given thing. In that question given that line m parallel to line l and p is the transversal. P is the transversal. Student, yesterday we learned that three types of different angles. These are corresponding angle, alternate angle, and interior angles. So, which type of angles are these? 3x and x. Student, these are the interior angles. Here, two parallel line and one transversal is given, and the measure of two interior angles are given. But when two parallel line and one transversal is given. Then the interior angles are supplementary. What is meant by supplementary, student? Supplementary means addition of these two angles should be 180 degree. So how we write it? 3x plus x is equal to 180. Just we give the reason here as which type of angles are this? Interior angle. 3x plus x is 4x and 4x is equal to 180. And hence we get the value of x as 180 divided by 4. If we divide it, we get it as 4 2 the 16 and 4 the 16 and 4 5 the 20. So we get its value as x is equal to 45. Now if you observe this option, that C option is the correct one option. So we tick here. In this way, we solve this question by using the property of two parallel lines and its transversals. Students, let us consider second question. Given that line A is parallel with line B and L is the transversal, then find x. Again, options are given, student, and figure is also given. In that figure, A is parallel with B and line L is the transversal. And these two angles are given here. And this angle measure is as 4x and this angle measure is given as 2x. But student, if we observe this two angle, 4x and 2x, these angles not make a pair of any angle. So, in that condition, we consider any different angle which make a pair with any one of the angles. So, let us consider here one angle and give its name as angle M. Any variable you consider, student, here. So we considered this angle and its measures we considered as M. Now if we observe here 2x and M makes a pair of vertically opposite angle and already we learned that vertically opposite angles are congruent. So 2x is equal to M. So how we write it? First we write the given thing. Line A is parallel with line B and L is the transversal. So, from figure we write here as M is equal to 2x. Just we give the reason vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angle. Now, if we observe 4x and L, what is the relation in between these two angles, student? Both of these are the interior angles. And when two parallel line and one transversal is given, interior angles are supplementary. And supplementary means its addition should be 180. So how we write this? 4x plus m is equal to 180. What is the reason for that? Again, interior angle. But the value of m is 2x. So we substitute this value here. 4x plus m is equal to 2x. That is equal to 180. 4x plus 2x is 6x is equal to 180. And hence x is equal to 180 by 6. And therefore we get value of x as 6 ones are 6, 6 threes are 18, and x is 30. If you observe this option, D option is given here as 30. So this is the correct option. So tick like that. Let us consider second question. In that question, given that line P is parallel with line Q and line T is the transversal. Again, line S is also one another transversal. And we have to find out here x and y. We have to find out here x and y. Student, if we observe this figure, angle 40 and angle x does not make any pair of angle. Any pair of angle means it does not make corresponding angle, it does not make alternate angle, and it does not make interior angle also. So just we consider any one of the angle such that it makes a pair with any one of the angle. So here we consider angle M. So right here represent angle M as shown in a figure. Represent angle M as shown in a figure. Now if we observe here angle 40 and angle M makes a pair of corresponding angle. And when two parallel line and one transversal is given, two parallel line means line P is parallel with line Q and T is the transversal here. Therefore, angle 40 and angle M makes a corresponding pair of corresponding angle. And these two angles are equal. So we write here directly as M is equal to 40. Just we give the reason here as corresponding angle. Corresponding angle. Now, if we observe the relation in between these two angles, this angle makes angle in linear pair. So, what is the relation in between angle in linear pair? Angle in linear pair is always 180 degree. So, we represent it as M plus X is equal to 180. And for that, give the reason here as angle in linear pair. But angle M is 40 degree. So in place of that, we substitute this value. So 40 plus X is equal to 180. And therefore, X is equal to 180 minus 40. And hence, the value of X should be 140. So we get the value of x as 140. Again, question is that find the value of y. Student, if we observe here y and angle 70, these two angles are not make a pair of any angle. So again, we considered here another different angle such as angle N. So here we consider angle N. So right here represent angle N as shown in figure. Student, if we observe these two angles N and 70, these two angles makes angle in linear pair, means the addition of both of these angles is 180 degree. So we write here as n plus 70 is equal to 180 degree. Again, we give the same reason here as angle in linear pair. Angle in linear pair. Student, properly write this same reason here. Now, just we find out the value of n. So, n is equal to 180 minus 70. So, we get here as 110. Value of n is 110. But they ask the question as find the value of y. If we observe the relation in between y and n, both of these angles are alternate angles. And we learn that when two parallel line and one transversal is given, the alternate angles are congruent. So we write here as but y is equal to n. What is the reason for that? Because these are the alternate angle. But the value of n is 110. Therefore, y is also equal to 110. So, in this way, by using the properties of angle formed when two parallel line and one transversal is given, we solve this type of a question and easily we find out the value of x and y.